Kickoff at Wachusett Regional High School in Holden, Massachusetts. Charter TV 3 presents coverage of Central Mass High School basketball. Tonight, it is a great mid-watch matchup as Wachusett hosts Nashoba on this cold, wintry evening in Central Massachusetts. Hello, everyone. Welcome inside the gymnasium. I'm Kevin Shea alongside of Kevin Wells. Happy New Year, everyone. This is a great way for us to kick off the high school season. Two teams still early in the season, kind of trying to find their identity, and especially with this Nashoba team that turned over a lot of players from a year ago.
Well, two teams, 1-5-3, the other 3-3, you're right. We're not even midway through the season. Identity crisis always happens in every single game. But you have two great coaches, two great storied programs. So tonight's matchup, Kevin, should be an outstanding one.
And we look at this matchup, at least on Wachusett's side, too. We're looking at one of the most dynamic backcourts in Central Mass. Joey Nuttall and Sam Dion averaging almost 30 points a game combined. These two are electric.
Well, it doesn't happen overnight. So those two guys right there, they take their time. They've been working together for the past couple years. They're experienced. They're veteran. They make every player on the floor that much better. It's going to be an outstanding game, as I said in the start.
All right, it's Wachusett and Nashoba. We're back with the opening tip-off right after this.
I'm District Attorney Joe Early, and I'm proud to partner with Charter Communications with our pledge to help raise awareness that bullying should not be tolerated. From local school students, here is our message.
If you see someone getting bullied, stand up for them. You never know what a few words can do.
We need to foster safe environments for students in their schools and their communities. Join the anti-bully crusade, take a stand to lend a hand, don't be a bully.
Presented by the Law Offices of Joseph J. Coriglia.
Local sports have a unique way of bringing families together, bringing generations together, bringing neighbors together. Central Mass, you have families that have been here for years, and you have grandparents that played at a certain high school, and they're watching their grandson or granddaughter play at their same high school. And there's something real special about that. Everyone comes out on a Friday night for football or to support the basketball team or the softball team, and everyone wants to support their team, and everyone feels, whether or not they have a son or daughter playing, or even if they don't know anyone on the roster, they come out because they went to school there or they're from that town. And for us to be able to cover that is really unique, really special, and really gratifying.
We'll run into people all the time, whether they're home from college or they're visiting family and they don't live in the area anymore. Or they'll say, hey, how's my team doing? How are these guys going to be this year? And so people remember where they came from. They remember their high schools. They remember their playing days.
And if you were from here, you know how unique and how special it is that you can get coverage of your high school and your college.
We have a bond with the community. They appreciate us. We appreciate them. To hear people cheer for you when you show up, because you're just there covering the game. We're not the game, but it's cool.
I've had people tell me that we've brought high school sports to a whole new level in Central Mass because of the way we cover high school sports and cover them like they're professional athletes.
Charter TV3 and UMass Memorial Healthcare have teamed up to bring you the latest news and trends in healthcare. Health Watch, presented by UMass Memorial Healthcare, brings you the healthcare topics that are important to you. From stroke prevention to allergies, skin care to sports injury prevention, and nutrition to pregnancy, Health Watch at UMass Memorial Healthcare informs you on the issues that affect you on a daily basis. Health Watch on Charter TV3. For extended interviews with UMass Memorial Healthcare experts, log on to our website.
All right, so here we go. Welcome back. We had the anthem. We had a
Moment of silence for Brian Quinn's mom, and that's why the Wachusett team wearing the warm-up jerseys with the pink around the W and on the back the SQ, as Brian Quinn's mom passed away after battling breast cancer last spring. So the team honoring her tonight and honoring her memory with the pink warm-up jerseys, and Tom Gibbons wearing a pink tie as well. The starting lineup for Wachusett: Sam Dion, Joey Nuttall. We talked about that great backcourt duo. Brian Quinn, Liam Griffin, and Hunter Johnson. So they have some height with Griffin and Johnson. And meanwhile, you look at Nashoba, Andrew Alquist, Justin Pierce, Breeze Hill, a key member of that Super Bowl football team in the fall, Jack Mueller and Jack Richard. So again, you have three seniors, but you got a couple sophomores in there as well. Hill, one of the captains, and boy, did he have a tremendous fall, Kevin, as a wide receiver and defensive back. And then they lost their quarterback, Sam Belinsky, broke his ankle in three places. I talked to him before the game. In that Super Bowl game, Breeze Hill had to play quarterback the rest of the game. So just a phenomenal athlete. They'll lean on him, his leadership, and his athleticism. Tom Gibbons has done just a tremendous job with this Wachusett program. This is a team that's always in contention. And, you know, they reflect the head coach with the style they play, that it's going to be a tough defensive style, that they are going to contest every shot, that they're going to go after every loose ball, they're going to dive on the floor, they're going to take charges.
They've never been in a game in the last several years where they haven't been competitive. The opposing coach always knows that they're going to have to protect the basketball, value the basketball, and they're going to have to take advantage of any mishaps or slip-ups that Wachusett might have, and they're far and few between.
Yeah, Danny Ortiz, too, another great coach, and always has this Nashoba team ready to go as well. And they will be ready tonight. We're ready for the opening tip-off.
You know, just a point of information, Danny Ortiz and the program, the job that he has done with his program, they have wreaked havoc and have been the Achilles heel of many a schools. And, of course, as you know, we've seen them several times in the Clark tournament over the last few years.
Yeah, certainly. Here they are. Nashoba, Breeze Hill, number 11, the captain, Jack Richard. So they'll lean on Hill for his leadership. He's a football player, but he's an athlete. So out there playing basketball, although it is not his number one sport.
So Wachusett matches up. Nashoba rotating through, so they pass to the wing and they run a shuffle cut through the high post. You know, a great way to identify if they're in a zone, if they're in a man, if they're in a matchup.
Here's Hill for three. And Nashoba starts off the scoring.
Well, Nashoba comes back in a 1-3-1 trap after they knock down that trifecta.
And here's a steal by Hill. Hill, little head fake. Dishes. Three for Richard. Off the back of the iron, loose ball. Collected by the Chieftains, and we got a foul on the floor as Justin Pierce took it hard to the rim.
Well, nice job by Pierce taking that bounce and get it inside the paint off his bounce. Opportunity to make two, jump out to a 5-0 lead here for Nashoba.
Pierce, one of the captains on this team. Second leading scorer on this Nashoba squad, Pierce averaging just under 12 points a game. Nashoba 3-3 overall, 1-1 in league play. Wachusett 5-3 overall and 3-0 in Midwatch A play. Midwatch A versus Midwatch B here tonight.
Here's that trap again. Effective the first time through, but Wachusett's a very intelligent, well-coached team. They will figure it out early going here.
Yeah, and with that veteran backcourt as well, there's Liam Griffin. He's a junior captain and one of the keys for this Wachusett team.
Nice
Tommy
job.
Tommy Gibbons says he's got to score for us.
Nice job by Griffin taking it off the bounce, getting it inside the seam.
Griffin's a football player as well, so he adds that grit and toughness to this Wachusett team. The Wachusett always has a couple of football players that make a big difference, whether or not they're basketball would be a primary sport for him. Good tic-tac-toe passing, but it's picked off by Richard. Second turnover of the ball game.
Now good hands defensively.
Here's Pierce, knocks down the three. And it's 6-2. Nashoba in front.
Right back to that 1-3-1.
Looks like this is going to be a staple from the defensive end for Nashoba.
Here's Dion for three. And he's just continuing a family tradition, Kevin, isn't he? The Dion hitting it up, lighting it up from downtown.
Well, I'll tell you what. But it goes back a few generations, too.
Doesn't it?
You know, from dad's being an outstanding player to grandpa being around the game forever and was quite a player back in the day when he played.
Yep, and coached as well.
Oh, yeah.
You know, so they come from a family of coaches and a basketball family. A deep three from Pierce, no good. Here's Dion looking for help. He's trapped out by midcourt. And it will be Nashoba ball. So that Chieftain defense causing some problems for Wachusett early on here. Nashoba with a one-point lead.
Yeah, unfortunately, Wachusett with a few turnovers. Dion did a nice job of stepping through that double team, but then he threw a bounce pass really low that got through the legs of his teammate.
Hill to Pierce up top. Pierce looking to penetrate, kicks it back out. Mueller for three. One of the tri-captains on this team. Wachusett going down low. Now they kick to the corner for Dion. Offensive rebound and put back. And Wachusett has their first lead of the ball game. That's Liam Griffin.
Liam Griffin doing a great job reading that bounce. Shot goes up from the wing. And on the weak side, perfect position to lay it back in.
Griffin has 4 points. And Wachusett with a one-point advantage, 7-6. And the foul is on Dion, his first.
You know, you're going to see Wachusett, Kevin, I'm sure, in the next couple trips. When Nashoba stays in that 1-3-1, they're going to invite the trap. And then the weak spot is the weak side low post. So look for them to go into the trap, ball fake, and then throw the ball to the low post on the weak side.
Penetration by Pierce, stolen.
Nuttall. Great defense.
Nuttall leading the break, gets it over to Gannon. The three, no good. Battle for the offensive rebound. And back comes Richard, who kicks it to the corner. Ahlquist off the mark, an offensive rebound. Nashoba with a couple cracks at it.
Pierce again, right place, right time.
Down low travel. And a travel.
Yeah. Great ball movement on behalf of Wachusett. Just a happy feet in the low post that time.
And now both teams going to their bench. And Patrick Walsh, the big fellow, actually it's Jake Serafini coming in, the senior center for Wachusett. Serafini adding some length to that Wachusett lineup. He'll battle Nathaniel French.
You know, Kevin, one of the things I want to highlight, when you watch Wachusett, okay, in the white on defense, when their man goes through away from the basketball, watch how they drop into a defensive triangle and they keep their eyes on the basketball at all times. They never lose eyesight of the basketball. That's just great coaching.
Nuttall gets it to Gannon. Jameson Gannon, great Irish name. Gannon lets it fly. Long rebound, it's collected there by Griffin. Stolen back by Nashoba. Nashoba on the run. They'll get it up top to Hill.
John Doros did a great job for Nashoba that time, stepping in.
An offensive foul on the pick. Nathan French will pick up his first. 3:05 to play, 7-6. Wachusett in front of Nashoba. Nashoba going to the bench as Ahlquist will come in, and Hill will get his first breather of the night. Breeze the Thrill Hill, as we called him during the fall on the frenzies.
So Wachusett goes 2-1-2, opposite the 1-3-1. That weak side low post is going to be the real soft spot against the 1-3-1.
Kevin, the bounce passes too. You see that. That's so key, especially anytime with pressure defense. The bounce pass is a much tougher pass to pick off or deflect.
Right. Oftentimes you get defense by accident just because people have their hands up and you throw a chest pass. But a bounce pass, that doesn't happen too often.
No, and I saw Wachusett do it a couple times on that last possession. You see it. I mean, that's Again, that doesn't happen by accident. That's just good coaching.
Nashoba foul on number 10, Jack Richard, his first, team second. Into the game for Nashoba, number 25, Ryan Donovan. And back into the game for the Mountaineers, number 34, Hunter Johnson.
Hunter Johnson, the sophomore, coming back in for Wachusett.
You know, again, Hunter Johnson, 6'3", he's long, young guy, just starting to get a great understanding of being exceptionally competitive at this level.
Yeah, he's a good rebounder for them. They like to him to get it going, get his offense going as well, be a dual threat for him. Wachusett has gone 4 minutes. Nashoba's gone 4 minutes without a field goal.
That information coming from our statistician extraordinaire.
Phil Robo, the best in the business. There's a big rebound from Johnson, the sophomore. And again, Wachusett trying to deal with that pressure. Very active zone.
Nashoba doing a great job. High hands, quick feet. Working very hard defensively. Nice pass inside.
Griffin battling for the offensive rebounds.
Nice pass, bullet pass into the low post. Liam Griffin goes up strong, he gets hit. Take a look at it. Nice dime pass into the low post. Griffin goes up, he gets hit, but he just can't finish. Opportunity for two.
We've been stuck on 7-6 for a while now, and Griffin ends that with the first free throw.
Wasn't that long ago, Kevin, as in less than a year ago, in this gymnasium, you wouldn't hear a noise for the first 10 points.
Oh, you're right. You're right. We talked about that, the silent night.
Right, and then they would go into a roar on the 11th point.
You're right. It was a great atmosphere. And the rebound there by Mueller. Wachusett on a 6-0 run. The Mountaineers with an 8-6 advantage over the Chieftains.
So a good matchup for Nashoba. You've got Wachusett coming from the Midwatch A division, and Nashoba is in the Midwatch B division. A great clash for Danny Ortiz and the Chieftains. Good look at the Sue Quinn on the back of these shirts. They just, I was talking to Tommy before the game, and coach said that they had just opened the box and they wanted to honor Sue Quinn. And what a classy and great way to do that. Certainly her son Brian, a key member of this team. Good look at the Wachusett there.
Yeah. Well, you know, being an educator and being in high school, just how much emotional support when a young kid loses a parent like that, how much that just a gesture like this provides emotional support for the high school student athlete, of knowing that, you know, you have an extended family that's wrapping their arms around you and saying we're here to help you, to support you, and to honor your family and your mom.
Yeah, I think that you know, you look at those shirts and it's truly an outward sign of an inward happening of how much these kids love each other as a family, you know, and certainly, like you said, a family that supports each and every one of them.
Yeah, Barry Walsh picks it off. He's a three-sport athlete, baseball, football, and basketball. I love he's got the headband going, too. He's an old-school player.
Oh, yeah,
Walsh,
it's a tight headband,
inside.
Too.
It is. I like it.
It's not a slick Watts,
no.
For those of you that are ancient like I am.
Slick Watts, I like it. I believe he was Slick Watts led the Celtics in scoring before Cedric Maxwell, and then on to the Larry Bird era.
Nice pass.
Yeah, they beat the pressure, and a foul on the Chieftains. Well, Johnson will go to the line.
Great job getting it into the post area. Nashoba collapsed. You know, there were two guys that kind of doubled down on him, and I think Jack Mayer. There's the dump into the low post. Great job looking up the court, and they called it on Mayer from the backside.
Johnson hits the first. Duros and Pierce checking back into the ball game for Nashoba. Johnson hits them both. Wachusett has their largest lead of the ball game, a four-point advantage. Shea Sullivan, the sophomore, coming in for Wachusett with the samurai haircut.
Well, looks good. Looks good with the man bun. Tough kid, plays really hard. You know, again, he's a very cerebral basketball player, is Sullivan. Understands the game.
Wachusett. So Nashoba's been stuck on six for a while here.
Wachusett doing a great job of matching up.
And they pick it up. Johnson picks it off. Playing the role of the free safety. 3 seconds remaining.
Nice pass.
Quinn rattles it home at the buzzer. Brian Quinn on the floater.
Well, great and job getting into the lane there. I thought he was going to shoot it at first, but he took it to the rack.
A three-point shooter, but he can show you that he can put it to the floor, and he's got the touch as well on the baseline. At the end of one, it is Wachusett 12, Nashoba 6.
I'm District Attorney Joe Worley, and I'm proud to partner with Charter Communications with our pledge to help raise awareness that bullying should not be tolerated. From local school students, here is our message.
If you see someone getting bullied, stand up for them. You never know what a few words can do.
We need to foster safe environments for students in their schools and their communities. Join the anti-bully crusade. Take a stand to lend a hand. Don't be a bully.
Presented by the law offices of Joseph J. Coriglia.
You can't get Worcester weather from a Boston TV station. The sun could be shining in downtown Boston, but the weather can be very different here in Worcester. People tell me all the time how much they count on our weather forecast, and we know how important that is to our Worcester News Tonight viewers. Each weekday, we'll give you your weather, your 10-day forecast for right here in Worcester, only on Worcester News Tonight.
Worcester's only local forecast, weeknights on Worcester News Tonight.
Well, it's a big bucket here for Wachusett. Time dwindling. They throw the skip pass over the top. Quinn, who could have pulled up, and that's one of his strengths, really shoots it, does a great job of taking it to the basket. Another look at it, different angle from your living room. Nice up and over. Good job protecting the basketball and getting it off. 12-6, Wachusett with the advantage.
Last Nashoba bucket came at the 6-11 mark of the first quarter. Here's Quinn. Wings it up top to Walsh. Nuttall. With eight on the shot clock, clears it out. Nuttall to the rack before the shot. Before the shot.
So they call the blocking foul on the penetration. Nice job getting to the basket. Could have been a big bucket for Wachusett, but the foul transpired. There's a penetration, but the foul transpired on the floor near the elbow as he started to penetrate to the basket. Oh, great feed, inbounds pass. You talk about the bounce pass, Kevin. There it is.
Griffin has 7 points. Wachusett has 14 overall in their largest lead. An 8-point advantage. Nashoba actually led by four at the 6-11 mark of the first quarter. Since then, it has been a 12-0 Wachusett run.
You know, if you think about it, Pierce started Nashoba off, and he knocked down that three right out of the gate. Then he hit another three, and that's where they stand with their score.
Danny McNulty into the ball game for Nashoba. His dad, John McNulty, a former Acton Boxborough standout, football and basketball. His uncle, Duffy McNulty, played for AB and then played for Providence College. Was a guard for the Friars. Beautiful job hitting the free throw line jumper by Griffin.
Well, great patience demonstrated by the Mountaineers that time as they kind of picked apart that 1-3-1 zone.
Griffin came in averaging 10.5 points a game. Second best on the squad to Dion's 19. Three players averaging in double figures, not all but 10. For Wachusett and the Mountaineers with another steal. 10-point advantage for Wachusett. They bring it up court. Here's Dion for three from the corner. Dion heats up. You can run away from a team in a hurry when you can hit threes like that.
Well, nice one-handed pass to the corner, and of course Dion pulls up and knocks it down.
So it is a 19-6 Wachusett advantage here in the second quarter. Tommy Gibbons is going to talk over some things with his team, but they've done a nice job at beating that press and that trap, and then Nashoba going to the man-to-man defense. But this is just transition basketball. It's creating the steal and the turnover and then getting up the court quickly.
Absolutely. You know, and the thing is, coming in, they take it off the bounce, one-handed pass to the corner as the defense collapse. And if you don't get out on Dion, in this case, and Nuttall, they're going to hurt you all day and all night. So it's really important that they make sure that they get out to cover.
Anna Botari at 10 o'clock will bring you Worcester news tonight at 10, giving you all of the local stories of the day from around Worcester and central Massachusetts. 10 o'clock right here on Charter TV 3, Worcester news tonight. Wachusett on a 17-0 run. 19-6, Mountaineers. Here's Breeze Hill. The quarterback, Sam Belinsky, as I mentioned, is doing the scorekeeping for the team. He said, I was going to get a job in the wintertime, but I can't because of my foot. Again, they broke his leg in three places during that Super Bowl at Gillette Stadium. So he said, I have a lot of friends on the team. I like basketball. I'm not a basketball player, but helping out the team. Great to see him. He's only a junior, too, so he'll be back next year, as will the Chieftains. And Coach Tucker will have another good squad. You can bet on that.
You know, Kevin, you bring up a good point, and the point is that when you're in high school, you need to take advantage of opportunities because it goes by. I used to always tell my kids, you know, it goes by in a blink of an eye. So here's a kid that's a great athlete that has a lot of friends. He doesn't want to miss out on anything. He wants to be a part. So, you know, I mean, he definitely got the message.
You're right. Danny Ortiz going to the bench. Here's Hill for three. No good. The rebound cleared there by Quinn. Now Dion up quickly. Johnson calling for it down low. Skip it to Dion. Good look at a three. Rebound cleared by Hill. Gets it over to Pierce. Pierce to the corner. Wachusett wanted to travel. Loose ball on the deck and still loose. Beautiful job by Pierce going behind the back to Ahlquist.
Yeah, just right behind his head. Great save.
Six on the shot clock and a three from Jack Richard.
The deep freeze is broken. Great job. Good patience by Nashoba and a nice kick out. Knocked down to three.
Wachusett with the ball in the lead. A 10-point advantage for the Mountaineers. Three ball off the side of the backboard. Nashoba will bring it up. Pierce, one of the tri-captain's hesitation move, drives, kicks it to the corner. Everett McConnell with his first shot. And down the other end, Joey Nuttall will go to the line and shoot a pair.
I think he hurt his hand a little bit.
Nuttall is the leader of this team. He's their emotional leader. As he goes, the team goes usually. Nuttall will shoot two. This is the first. Walsh is going to come in, replacing Quinn. Walsh is going to play baseball in college.
I don't mean to give away Breeze Hill's secret. I know you like his headband, but it's J-Rap.
Is that what it is?
Yeah, yeah. Of course, J-Rap, that's used to...
pre-wrap for, like, sprained ankles and stuff?
Exactly, exactly. I just happened to notice that. He checked in right in front of me.
Yeah, he did.
20-9, the
Mountaineers. Walsh, he's a great baseball player, as I mentioned. He's gonna play baseball in college, committed last spring. Good rebound by Dion. One thing you notice with this Wachusett team, Kevin, is how well they rebound as a team. The guards all get involved.
Well, I think that Coach Gibbons makes sure that they understand it takes five players to play every aspect in every second of every game. So the guards rebound. It's not where, you know, the one and the two don't have to rebound. We're going to look to outlet the ball and run. One, two, three, four, and five are all going to the glass. They're all responsible for boxing out.
They get it into Dion.
Nashoba matches man-to-man now.
So Wachusett spreads the floor a little bit.
High ball screen.
Griffin sets the screen. Dion now. Mueller on him. Beautiful pass from Dion. And a conversion from Johnson. Hunter Johnson with the conversion, but boy, was that a bullet pass.
Well, Sam Dion, they run a clear out. He penetrates through the lane and just throws that dime pass, like you said. 100 miles an hour.
Here's a steal by Dion. And knocked away from behind and a foul on Hill. Dion will go to the line and shoot two.
Nashoba foul, number 11, Reese Hill, his first.
Well, here it is, right from the steal all the way to the foul. Sam Dion takes it hard to the basket. He gets hit.
Dion averaging 19 points a game, one of the leading scorers in Central Massachusetts. Jack Mueller for Nashoba. I believe that's a happy birthday to Jack, the senior. Here comes Danny McNulty, the junior for Wachusett. Danny plays football as well.
Dion gets a well-deserved break, 24-9. The Mountaineers with the lead as we approach the three-minute mark here in the second quarter.
Here's Danny McNulty. Junior guard as some bodies hit the deck in the paint. There he is. Talked to his dad before the game.
Liam
basketball and football player. John, actually, his senior year, we're preseason scrimmage against Natick, broke his leg and blew his knee out on the same play and worked all season long to get back and actually played in the Thanksgiving Day game.
Well, I'll tell you, that's determination, because those are two injuries that certainly can put you down for more than a season.
It was brutal. Nice pick. Griffin couldn't convert.
Yep.
Johnson's going to get the foul.
Yeah, Hunter Johnson just pushing with his back a little bit too much there.
His grandfather was our former principal, Doc McNulty. Great guy. Tremendous guy and a great principal. And he was a big basketball guy as well.
Yeah, I've heard some stories about your years in high school from good old Doc McNulty.
Oh, he was the best. Kept law and order. Here's a deep three.
Big bucket by Jack Mayer.
Mayer.
Is that 1-3-1 again? Yeah, Doc McNulty, you know, the word on the street is that you, during your, especially junior, but most especially your senior year, broke the record for the most push-ups in school history.
I had to do a lot of push-ups my senior year, courtesy of Dr. McNulty.
Now notice I didn't talk that wasn't, I didn't say it was in phys ed class. I didn't say that it was,
And they were all warranted too. Every single one that I did, I earned.
Do you want to expound on?
No, we can just leave it at that.
Okay.
They were done in the calf, in the hall, in his office. You know, they were handed out randomly, and certainly every single one of them I deserved and I earned. It was a good deterrent, having to do push-ups in front of your classmates.
Nice
drive to the basket. Yeah, Ahlquist.
Getting right through the middle. Andy Ahlquist. He's only a sophomore. Nice job using his left hand.
Good defense. Ahlquist gets up and bats it away. 20 seconds on the shot clock. 1:42 remaining here in the first half. 24-14. Wachusett in front. And the Mountaineers go to the bench. Dion comes in, replaces Walsh. Nashoba on a 5-0 run to get within 10. Dion skips it over to Nuttall. Dion going inside, moves the ball very well, stripped away. Here comes McNulty.
Nice job defensively that time.
Three from the corner, nothing but net. Jack Richard with a three, and all of a sudden we got a ball game again. It's a 7-point game.
A little bit of a spark. Things are swaying a little bit. Nashoba playing with confidence.
Dion, one-handed. Sweet look, Nuttall for three. Battle for the offensive rebound, out of bounds. It will be Nashoba ball.
So Kevin, what's interesting about the 1-3-1 that Nashoba is running is that they try to trap in the corners. So they let you go to the wing and they play you straight up. Once it goes to the corners, that low post guy goes out and they try to run a double. The other thing that they can do when they need to turn up the heat is to deny the reversal to the strong side wing.
Good block that time, good defense from Wachusett. Off on the Mountaineers, Nuttall with that tremendous defense, 43 and a half seconds remaining in the first half.
Take a look at this, talk about great timing. Goes straight up, gets all ball on the penetration to the basket.
Pierce for three. Justin Pierce heating up, he's got two threes. It's a 4-point game. Pierce averaging 12 a game, an 11-0 run for Nashoba. And the Chieftains have time back in it. They caused the turnover, a lot of life on that Nashoba bench right now as they're playing with some momentum. Hallquist all smiles. They have knocked this lead down to four. Two possession ball game, McNulty up top.
Wachusett matches up once again, doing a good job defensively. A little bit of daylight, and Nashoba has got a spark. They're shooting the basketball very well right now.
And they're gonna hold for the final shot of the first half. Pierce to the corner for McNulty, and corralled there by Wachusett. A good flurry at the end from Nashoba as they climb back into this ball game. First half comes to a close. It is Wachusett 24 and Nashoba 20. We're back with all of our halftime activities right after this. Safety, 3 seconds remaining.
Nice pass.
Quinn rattles it home at the buzzer. Bryan
save.
Six on the shot clock and a three. Mueller on him. Beautiful pass from Dion. And a conversion from Johnson. And welcome back, everyone. Our halftime statistics, Wachusett shooting 36% from the field and Nashoba 29%. And the three-point field goal percentage, Nashoba heating up at the end of the first half to get right back in this ball game. Rebounding advantage for the Mountaineers of Wachusett, 19-11. The turnovers about even, and the points off turnovers about even as well.
Well, I think those statistics really tell a lot of the tale of the first half. You know, if you looked at Neshoba's three-point field goal percentage midway through the second period, it certainly wouldn't be close to 43%. But as you said, they really heated up. It was a game that could have gotten away from them very easily. They did a nice job. They stayed with the 1-3-1 defensively, created a couple more turnovers. I think Wachusett has done a nice job of figuring that trap out. But Neshoba got themselves right back in the ballgame, and now we got a 4-point ball game.
Yeah, game of runs. Nashoba opened up, as you said, with the lead, and Wachusett went on a 22-3 run. And then Nashoba closing out the half on an 11-0 run.
Jack Richard doing a nice job there. Shot fake, dribbled into open space, pulled up and knocked one down. 2-point ball game.
Here we go, every possession now becomes so critical. Here's Dion and Nuttall up top. Good tic-tac-toe passing down low and the reverse layup from Leon Griffin.
Well, I'll tell you, so important that time to do a reverse layup. He protected the basketball with his body. He did a nice job off the window and in. Big steal.
11 points for Griffin. Dion on the break, 2-on-2. Here's Quinn for three. In and out. Offensive rebound, knocked around, and it will be Wachusett basketball. Good battle underneath from Hunter Johnson.
Well, Johnson, you know, again, only a sophomore, did a great job getting his hands on the basketball, and then it went off in the Nashoba player's leg. 1-4 out of bounds play for the Mountaineers. Oh, great inbounds play. You know, again, Kevin, the bounce pass, just what you talked about. It's the second time that Wachusett has dumped the ball from out of bounds, bounce pass into the post area for lay-in.
Deep three off the iron. Quinn the rebound. Dion in the corner looking, gets to Nuttall. They skip it over to Johnson, now to the corner again. Wachusett moving the ball quickly, making that defense move their feet.
Got to be honest, Kevin, the 1-3-1 is difficult to play. So once again, you can see the coaching of Danny Ortiz. They do an outstanding job of dropping from the weak side into the low post area. You know, again, I had mentioned that that's the soft spot, but Nashoba has done an amazing job of that weak side guy dropping down into the low post to take away the passing lane.
Yeah, Holy Cross plays that 1-3-1. And as you mentioned, it is. Remember, that was the key when they made that run a couple years ago into the NCAA tournament, was the 1-3-1. But it is very difficult. It's difficult for college kids to pick it up.
Right, right. So right now, Nashoba has stayed with this the entire ball game. I don't think Danny Ortiz is going to change that.
Dion with an NBA three.
Well, he was almost sitting in the bleachers.
Oh, man. He was in the first row of the concession stand right there. Dion's got three threes tonight and 10 points. 31-22, Wachusett in front. Mayer looking for help, finds it. Here's Pierce. And the rebound by Nuttall. Nuttall clearing it out. Got to move the ball quickly against this defense. Boyd Nashoba doing a great job and ripped away. Liam Griffin just ripping the ball away.
Well, they ran that double team in the post and did a great job. Ball go back over. Here it is. Here's the double team. Nice job dropping down. Brian Quinn just getting after it defensively.
5 minutes to play in the third quarter. Wachusett in front, 31-22. Three from Mayer, no good. Dion the rebound. Hill, and he is fouled. Griffin will pick up the foul, his first.
Yeah, great hustle by Liam Griffin, but you know, just a loose ball foul.
Second on Griffin. Here's Justin Pierce, one of the tri-captains for Nashoba. Hill looking down low. Good save. Here comes Griffin. Griffin with a sweet handle, up and in. Liam Griffin showing off the skills as he goes coast to coast.
You know, Kev, 6'3", he's a strong kid, knows how to get himself into the lane. Real nice play there.
And the rebound taken there by Justin Jamison Gannon. And the foul before the shot. The foul's on Alquist. Alquist picking up his first. 11-point Wachusett lead. Under 4 minutes to play in the quarter. The runner, no good. Rebound, Richard lost it out of bounds. Jack Richard, just a sophomore for this Nashoba team.
Well, here's that 1-4 out of bounds play. Again, they threw a bounce pass twice right into the low post. They did a nice job of sealing, opening up. Let's see what happens here.
Richard leads this Nashoba team in scoring at 12 a game. And there's a steal. Richard.
Yeah, missed opportunity. Liam Griffin was wide open.
Here's Hill. Hill crossing over, left-handed, up, no good.
Again, one of those runs right now where Nashoba just can't get the basketball to go through the cylinder.
There's Dion up top. Wachusett on a 9-0 run to start the second half. It was Nashoba that closed the half on an 11-0 run to get back in this game. Pierce on the wing. Pierce bottled up. Up top to Mayer. Hill looks for help, finds it
eight
with Richard.
On the shot.
Beautiful defense from Hunter Johnson with the steal. Johnson taking it himself, and he draws. Nope, doesn't draw the foul. They were, everyone stopped expecting the whistle. Everyone expected the whistle, including us. Everyone froze for a little minute there and nothing. No harm, no foul, they're saying, although Joey Nuttall would disagree. He checks his jaw with 2:45 to play in the third quarter. We want to say hello to Bill Gibbons Sr., who's watching at home tonight, the father of Tommy Gibbons. Bill Gibbons, too, the Holy Cross women's basketball coach. Bill Gibbons Sr., one of the great guys and great basketball minds in central Massachusetts. Coached for years at Doherty High School, at North High School. So proud of his sons following in his footsteps. Tommy Gibbons, he's done a stellar job with this Wachusett program. .245 to play in the quarter. Friday night we'll be down at Sutton, Dual Valley. Sutton taking on Hopedale. Sutton's a great team. Jimmy Donnelly always has that team ready to play. I saw them play early in the season against Burncoat, a good Burncoat team. Sutton beat them. No secret there that, you know, everyone on Sutton's roster can hit the three. They're a fun team to watch, and it's a great atmosphere, too. They get the student section. They call it the Barnyard, you know, and they get it going.
Again, with Sutton, you know, they've been hitting the three for decades.
Oh,
this
yeah.
isn't something that's
no,
new.
No, no.
You know, I think it's...
I think they put Nerf hoops up in the cradles. You
it's
know,
something in the water, there's no doubt about
in
it.
In the crib. They all get Nerf hoops in their cribs.
But that Hopedale-Sutton rivalry is huge. It's always a battle, so it should be a great game for us to cover.
Yeah, Tony Cordani, the Hopedale coach, and Jimmy Donnelly, they've had some legendary battles. They have a lot of respect for each other, too. Nashoba with the chance to cut into that lead, an 11-point deficit. McNulty.
There we go. Nice pass off the drive. Good finish by Danny McNulty.
Here is Nuttall. Gannon. Dion on the wing. Nashoba's gone back to the man-to-man defense. Dion. Richard the rebound. He's fouled by Hunter Johnson. He picks up his second.
Yeah, loose ball. Dion, a little dipsy doodle, just couldn't get it to go. Hit the bottom of the glass.
Both teams averaging in the mid-50s scoring-wise and defensively giving up in the mid-50s.
At this pace, they're probably both going to help their defensive average a tad.
That's what it looks like. It certainly appears that way. Barring some sort of offensive explosion from either team. McNulty spins to the middle, kicks it back to Mayer. Long rebound, corralled there by Griffin. Nuttall with McNulty on him. Nuttall elevates off the window for two. Nuttall has 3 points tonight. He's been held in check, averaging 10 a game.
Great defensive effort right now going on by Wachusett.
And the leaner from Justin Pierce. Pierce has 8 points tonight.
Pierce is a strong kid. He knows how to give himself space. He's very smart with the ball in his hands.
Again, Dion, and certainly the Nashoba team very aware when Dion has the basketball. Six on the shot clock. Gannon a deep three. McNulty the rebound. Alquist crossing over. Alquist going
nice
strong
move
to the net. Alquist playing with a little fire. He's got 4 points tonight. It's a 7-point game.
Only a sophomore.
Nuttall and Dion. was a difference of about 2 seconds between the shot clock and the game clock. Turnaround, no good. Richard the rebound for Nashoba. Chieftains can hold for the final shot if they want. Loose ball. Richard, or Pierce has it. 3 seconds. Alquist for three. And the rebound, Liam Griffins. 1 quarter remaining. Wachusett with the lead at home, 35-28. Fourth quarter's coming up next.
I'm District Attorney Joe Early, and I'm proud to partner with Charter Communications with our pledge to help raise awareness that bullying should not be tolerated. From local school students, here is our message.
If you see someone getting bullied, stand up for them. You never know what a few words can do.
We need to foster safe environments for students in their schools and their communities. Join the anti-bully crusade. Take a stand to lend a hand. Don't be a bully.
Presented by the Law Offices of Joseph J. Coriglia.
You can't get Worcester weather from a Boston TV station. The sun could be shining in downtown Boston, but the weather can be very different here in Worcester. People tell me all the time how much they count on our weather forecast, and we know how important that is to our Worcester News Tonight viewers. Each weekday, we'll give you your weather, your 10-day forecast for right here in Worcester, only on Worcester News Tonight.
Worcester's only local forecast, weeknights on Worcester News Tonight.
All right, so there is Jack Mayer, the senior for Nashoba, as the Chieftains looking at a 7-point deficit to start the fourth quarter. Wachusett shooting 36% from the field, and Nashoba 32% from the field in this game.
Had a very quick third quarter. Two fouls called on Wachusett and one call on Nashoba.
And there's Gannon. Jamison Gannon with his first 2 points of the night.
Little one-handed leaner into the lane.
Jamison Gannon.
And knocked out of bounds by Wachusett. Two players going for the Mountaineers. Just aggressive play. Can't fault them. And now Nashoba will get a second crack at it. Mayer up fake. Goes up too strong. Gannon the rebound. Gannon and Nuttall bringing it up. McNulty waits at half court. Dion off the screen. Offensive rebound. Up and in. Liam Griffin just a beast underneath.
Well, and again, you know, he anticipated getting hit, so he used his body so exceptionally well.
It's an 11-point advantage right now for Wachusett. Pierce blocked, gets his own rebound, goes up and draws the foul. So Justin Pierce will shoot two. Gannon picks up the foul, his first.
Justin Pierce shoot free throws for the Chieftains.
Pierce shooting two.
Nice soft touch.
Back into the game for Mountaineers. Number 11, Barry Walsh. And 34,
Hunter. Wachusett going to the bench. Barry Walsh coming into the ball game along with Hunter Johnson. Pierce hits them both. 10 points for Justin Pierce. Came in averaging 12 a game. It's a 9-point Wachusett advantage with 6:40 to play in the game. Here's Walsh. As we mentioned, a three-sport athlete and a tremendous baseball player. He'll be playing baseball in college. Here's Walsh on the drive. Walsh, good touch in the lane.
Nashoba in a man-to-man defense there, and Walsh took advantage of it from the wing.
Loose ball, corralled there by Mayer. Here's McNulty, and McNulty draws the foul. The reach in on Walsh. Walsh picks up his first.
Number 11, Barry Walsh, his first, team four. Chieftain basketball out of bounds.
Joey! Hunter! Hey!
Pierce up top. Looks at it, now puts it to the floor. Pierce has Johnson on him. Good defense from Hunter Johnson. Standing his ground, may have gotten a hand on the shot. Nuttall. In traffic through the lane, loose ball, body's hitting the deck. McNulty comes away with it, he's got numbers. Wachusett gets back now. The three from Richard, no good. Offensive rebound, Mayer. Dion battles in there. Nuttall keeps it alive, still loose. It's like a fumble in football, everyone's going for it. And it's gonna be Wachusett basketball.
Great hustle by both teams.
I think everyone on the floor at some point hit the deck. All 10 players at some point are going to have a floor burn from the last 15 seconds of action.
Well, I'll tell you, when we play that back, it's going to take a little bit of time, but timeout, Wachusett. Incredible hustle on behalf of both teams.
Yeah, it was great. Great to see. It was literally like a fumble in football, guys just diving after it. Everyone hitting the deck for it. Last touch by Nashoba, so it'll be Wachusett basketball with 5:32 to play in the game. Kevin Shea alongside of Kevin Wells and Phil Robo. Thanks for joining us tonight for Central Mass High School basketball. Here's another look at this, the hustle and everyone hitting the deck on this.
I mean, nobody can pick it up. It just keeps going out of, all over the court. Yep.
And down the other end in the lane, you had bodies hitting the deck down there.
Here it is from a different angle. Great save.
Look at the bodies hitting the deck. Outstanding.
I'll tell you.
We got a great seat. There's Phil Robo looking great as ever. You saw him during the during that replay. He looks svelte. He looks spry. I did not see Rusty Egan, a man for all seasons. Contractually, I don't believe we're allowed to show Rusty without notification from his representatives. He does have a lucrative shoe and clothing contract, apparel contract, so we did not get clearance from his people.
You notice Phil is not only looking fit, but he's starting to look tan. He's getting ready for his big trip.
Yeah, his Aruba sojourn, the annual Aruba sojourn. He is, he's starting to tan it up.
It's electric.
Nuttall. Offensive foul.
Nashoba doing a great job. Two players stepping in to draw the charge there.
Richard and McNulty both taking the charge. Oh, now Phil's a homeowner, though, in Florida. I forgot about that. So now it's not going down to Aruba anymore. Now he's going to his place down in Florida. He's a homeowner down there.
Now, what part of Florida is that?
He's in Naples, yeah.
Oh, very nice.
A phenomenal place down there.
Little she.
Yeah, very she. McNulty underneath for two. Danny McNulty's got 4 points tonight.
I mean, nothing for nothing. Did you happen to get an invitation to go to Naples like for a weekend or anything?
I have not garnered the invite yet.
Yeah, I've been checking my mail as well to no avail.
I love it. Now, interestingly enough, during the hurricane, Phil did offer if I wanted to go down, I could stay for free during the hurricane just to kind of house sit and ride it out. To make sure no water came in.
I can't blame him for that. You know, if you can find someone to always
take care
of your place, I can respect that.
During a perilous time, weather-wise. Here's Dion. Dion with a scoop. Couldn't get it to fall. Pretty move, though. Pierce coming back the other way. Pierce to McNulty on the
nice
run.
Nice break.
Tic-tac-toe. Richard, no good. Nashoba needed that one. With 4:22 to play. Staring at a 9-point deficit. Walsh gets it up top to Griffin. Griffin has been just a monster tonight for Wachusett. Here's
nice
Walsh looking at a three. And the rebound by Mayer. Alquist on the drive, bottled up by Griffin. Griffin has played this game from end to end.
Nice job defensively by Wachusett.
Mayer with a three, and Nashoba quickly calls for a timeout. 6-point game, so a two-possession game right now. Nashoba wants a timeout. Do you think we'll see the 1-3-1 out of this?
Gotta
or
be
do you
honest.
Think some kind of trap.
You know what? I think there's too much time left. I think that when they went man-to-man here in the second half, they've done some great things defensively, have the Chieftains. So it would be surprising. I think their success in the second half has come from their man-to-man. But you never know.
Right.
You know, they did get I can't say a lot, but they created some turnovers out of that 1-3-1. Plenty
we'll
of time.
Yeah, 3:46 to play, as you mentioned, is a ton of time in basketball. It's a two-possession game now. A six-point lead for Wachusett. We'll see what Wachusett dials up here in the huddle. Great coaching staff that Tommy Gibbons has.
So Nashoba
appears they're going to extend, right?
Yep, they do match up. They stay man-to-man.
Wachusett's been looking for some consistency here early on in the season. String together a few wins and a few good games in a row, and this is a good test for them. Good battle, Nuttall and McNulty. Here's Griffin. The left-handed lay-in.
You know what, he's really fluid. He uses both hands exceptionally well. Nice job getting to the basket that time.
17 points for Liam Griffin tonight. He's got to have double figures in rebounds as well. He's been a monster.
Nice back door cut that time by Nashoba, but it was negated by a kick ball.
McNulty will put it in play for Nashoba to Richard. Here's Pierce. Pierce puts it to the floor. The drive up and in. Tough two from Justin Pierce.
Nice strong move. Here's the full court pressure.
12 points from Pierce. Back to a six-point game. Here's Griffin up top with Mayer on him. Nuttall. McNulty trying to force him to the left.
Wachusett's done a great job of answering the bell every time that they have been challenged.
Tommy Gibbons calling for a timeout with 2:43 to play in the ball game. 13 seconds remaining on the shot clock. 6-point Wachusett advantage. Brian Quinn's going to check into the ball game for Wachusett. Quinn averaging 5.5 points a game. Griffin came in averaging 10.5. He has put up 18 here tonight.
Great penetration here and a nice finish by Pierce. You know, another one of those tough kids that just gets it to the basket, goes up strong, gets hit, does a nice job finishing. 6-point advantage for Wachusett. They've got 13 seconds to work with. On the clock and the possession.
The question I have for Phil Robo, our statistician, will you be in Naples for St. Patrick's Day? Because I am told Naples has a very good St. Patrick's Day parade. Coming home on the 15th. Well, that doesn't surprise me. The holiday. You should be down there for the holiday. You know, my guess is in a couple years, Phil's going to be in the parade.
My guess is that being Irish, Mr. Shea.
Yep.
Maybe he's reserving that time for you.
Oh, I like that. I like that. Griffin with a strong move in the paint and just a great drop step.
Yeah, Liam Griffin, you know, showing it all on the inside, having a great game for the Mountaineers.
Here's big a steal by Griffin. Griffin, good handle too.
Great
sweet
movement.
Pass down low. Quinn for three. Deflected back out. Pierce collects. 2:13 to play. Richard to Pierce. Pierce puts it to the floor. Mayer for three. Rebound by Nuttall. Three white jerseys underneath for that rebound. Under 2 minutes to play. An 8-point Wachusett lead. Nuttall draws the foul on McNulty. McNulty picks up his first.
It's only the third team.
Wachusett had a 17-0 run during the second quarter, first and second quarter. Then Nashoba opened or closed the half on a 14-0 run. And then Wachusett opened up on a 9-0 run. It's been a game of runs. Griffin up top, and Wachusett would like to eat a little bit of this clock if they could. We're under a minute 45 to play.
Nashoba only has 3 team fouls. I'm surprised they're not gambling and being more aggressive defensively.
Dion draws the foul, so Dion's going to shoot 2.
Nashoba foul number 10.
That'll be
the
4th team foul.
Richard picks up his 3rd, the sophomore. 1:37 to play in the game. 45-37. Wachusett with the lead.
Into the game for Nashoba. 5, John Ferros. And for the Mountaineers, number 11, Barry.
Both teams going to the bench. Here is Sam Dion. Dion hits. He's been held for him in check with 11 points tonight. Below his season average of 19.
Well, 3 threes, which, you know, obviously is his mainstay to his game, is his ability to shoot the basketball.
Wachusett foul number 12, Joey Nuttall, his 2nd, team 6.
46-37, a 9-point advantage for Wachusett with a minute 24 to play in the game. Nashoba looking to get some points and get them quickly. Here's Breeze Hill. Pierce on the baseline, trapped there. Hill, Mayer for 3. Rattles around, no good. Johnson the rebound, and
halfway
Johnson
in.
Is fouled.
A loose ball foul on Pierce. That'll be the team's 5th, I believe. Well, you talk about how important it is to rebound the basketball. Wachusett doing a great job. Nice rebound. Again, Hunter Johnson goes up strong.
Time on the floor, Wachusett.
106 to play in the game. Tom Gibbons with the timeout. They will have the ball and a 9-point advantage. Possession arrow favors Nashoba right now. One of the assistant coaches, Chris O'Donnell for Wachusett, tweeted out last night during the national championship football game that if Alabama would go to their backup quarterback, they would win the national title. It was very prophetic. That's what they did, and that's what they ended up doing.
You know, a good look as we kick off this high school season at the cheerleaders. And every year we try to give them, pay them homage with the commitment and dedication it takes for cheerleading. We always talk about how it's so different today than it once was. The competitions, the dance routines, the hours of practice. So hats off to the cheerleaders, not only in the gym tonight, but all over.
Wachusett gets it into Griffin. Back over to Nuttall. And we got a foul. Is it on the floor?
Yeah.
Okay.
So it'll be a 6th. It won't be a 1-on-1.
Walsh.
58 seconds remaining. We've got 30.
Here's Griffin. Doesn't get it to drop. He'll go to the line with 55 seconds remaining. It is a 9-point game right now.
Well, again, he's had such a great game. Nice job, step in the middle, goes up strong, protects the basketball.
Griffin hits the free throw, he'll have 1 more.
Nice soft touch.
20 points for Liam Griffin tonight. Griffin hits them both, 21 points. Can't do much more than Griffin did for Wachusett tonight through the fingertips of the intended receiver for Nashoba. It's an 11-point advantage for Wachusett. Nashoba's gonna go for the steal and extend as they foul right away. So Nuttall's gonna go to the line and shoot 1-1.
Follow on Nashoba's number two, Justin Pierce, his second teammate. Joey Nuttall will shoot 1-1 for the Mountaineers.
And then go follow trophies. Clock here.
1-1. Here we go, 1-1.
Under a minute to play. Nuttall hits the first. He's got 4 points tonight. One of the grinders for this Wachusett team. Does all the little things. He scores for him as well. He's 10 points a game. But plays tremendous defense, dives for loose balls, takes charges, sets the tone for this Wachusett team.
One of the rudders that stabilizes the ship.
That's it right there. And a three in the corner from Andrew Alquist. And Nashoba with a quick timeout.
Alquist is only a sophomore. He's showing his ability to shoot the basketball. So he's making a statement tonight, certainly about his athleticism and his ability to be a quality basketball player as he gets more time under his belt. Big bucket right there. Good look at it. Stepped out just behind the arc, about a 23-footer. Nice soft touch.
Makes it a 9-point game. 49-40 with 37.9 seconds remaining. And so you would guess Nashoba is going to press and then go for the steal. If you don't get the steal, you foul. And put Wachusett at the line for 1-1.
You've really become quite the coach over the years.
It is. Well, sitting next to you, I learned.
You've absorbed
learned
so much.
Through osmosis.
Yeah.
Although I still don't know if I've picked up, like, stats-wise, I was never good at stats. That was one of my weakest subjects in college. We had to take one semester of it. It was not good for me. I tried to get half credit on the test, so I cannot replicate, Phil, what you do. And here's before the, oh, they're counting it.
Oh.
Wow, NBA style. The continuation. Johnson the hoop and the hack, and he'll go to the line. With a chance for a three-point play, he has got 8 points tonight.
There it is. Oh, very good call. Contact as he's on his way up.
Yeah, officials do a tremendous job. You and I see it, throughout the Worcester County, but they do. The officials do a phenomenal job. And I know when you were a coach, you didn't always feel that way.
Well, I've been making amends now. I've been doing this big bucket.
You're right. You've softened as an announcer, Jack Richard with a three.
Big bucket. Yeah, back in the day, I was a little intense, I would say. And, I think I've been doing this for well over 20 years now.
Yeah.
And
you have.
I've been making amends every year to the officials.
Yep.
If the masses were still in Latin like they were when I used to be an altar boy. I used to be an altar boy, you know.
I like that. I was,
too. Yeah. And, my mother was convinced I was going to be a priest. And obviously that didn't,
nope,
you know, as an Irish Catholic, that didn't
play
happen.
Out.
It just didn't work. But
the good Lord had other plans for you.
Yeah. No, it is what it is.
I remember, I don't know, they don't do this anymore because now you see the priest will read and the Bible's up on the altar. But we used to have to hold the Bible. They'd have this huge Bible. And, you know, you're a little kid. You're in, like, fifth grade as an altar boy. And I remember that just being very heavy and trying to hold it still.
Yeah, we used to do rock, paper, scissors to see who was going to have the loser had to hold the Bible.
That was a tough that, and I remember lighting the candles, too, behind the altar. You know, and you'd have to just that small book of matches. It wasn't like they had the big ones where you didn't have to worry about your fingers getting burnt. It was that small book. Well, now they have, of course, those plastic devices that make it so much easier.
See, everyone believes that there's 30 years or so difference between you and I in age.
No, there is not.
You just have a better hair color than I do.
That's right. Nice and easy. Nice and easy for men. Release. 23 seconds remaining in this one, a 9-point advantage for Wachusett. Nuttall hits.
Good game to kick off the high school season this year. You know, in 2018, two quality high school teams with two quality coaching staffs. Wachusett had the opportunities to open things up, but Nashoba, with the never-say-die attitude, kept it going.
You're right, an offensive foul.
Yeah, good call, Mr. Pierce. You know, once you put that forearm up, your non-dribbling hand, you're in trouble. You know, and that's kind of what happened.
Phil Robo actually lived across the street from a church. This is the true story. And if he wasn't at Mass, the priest would come get him. And I would guess that the priest probably wore a path from the church to Phil's front door, getting him a lot, that Phil would be, you know, ready for Our Lady of the Mattress. Just trying to catch a few more winks, and the priest would say, no, you don't. Let's go. As you mentioned, it was a good one to kick off the high school season for us. Wachusett holding serve here at home as they defeat Nashoba 53-43. Our next broadcast will come your way this Friday night. It is Sutton and Hopedale, and you can see the game live right here on Charter TV 3 at 7 p.m. For Kevin Wells, Phil Robo, Sean Grady, and our entire Charter TV 3 crew, I'm Kevin Shea. Thanks for watching. So long from the mountaintop, where Wachusett and Hunter Johnson are victorious here tonight.